jams. Stop trying to die with the fucking jam.
What?
Josh is trying to die with Def Jam, but little does he know he'll never be Def Jam. So stop trying to be Def Jam because you're never going to be Def Jam, JStew. And JStew said, who's Def Jam? And I'm like, shut the fuck up.
If you can't hear the jam.
You're deaf in this fucking jam. You're going, yeah, Miss Wallace on me.
You're paying for my taxi cab.
No one even rides taxis anymore.
I'm such an old soul. And this body. Just kidding. Okay. She packs her stuff inside a yellow bag. She realizes this is the last. With her mother.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Woo-hoo! We are Woo-hoo! Back. That's right. That's my little, well, we'll get to that. That's my little co-host over here. He might be called Little Joker, and I am Steven. Steven with a PH like always. But today, I'm Puppet. On the Who Cares podcast.
Oh my God, who the hell cares?
Who cares?
What do women want? Who cares?
That's right, who the F cares? Because we're trying to be a little bit, nice with it. Because we're back in 1967 with the smooth sounds of Whittier Boulevard. And we're you and I, Little Joker, JStew, back again. The original producer of this podcast, he's come to bless us with his talents again. JStew, how you doing?
Doing pretty good. How are you?
AKA Little Joker.
AKA Little Puppet.
Okay, that's Little Puppet. I'm Puppet.
Oh, okay, sorry. Puppet.
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 That's right. And we're sitting here. We're sitting here on the bench. Sitting in the park waiting for you. Oh, wow.
It's just a warm summer night.
It's just a warm summer night, even though it's in March, but it is. But I feel like it is a warm summer night tonight. Just you and me.
Sitting outside.
Just watching the cars go by, watching the little hyenas.
Okay.
Girls from Wicked Babies.
Okay. Anyways.
So we're just sitting here. We've been just mellowing out to like the sweet sounds of the night.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Stu. What brings you, before we get on to this, I just want to thank everybody for, again, listening to our podcast. And this is going to be a little more mellow. So while you're feeling it, while you're feeling the mellowness of this, while you're feeling the smooth sounds, if you're listening to the Chai Lights, if you're listening to the Four Tops, if you're listening to
These Nuts.
Okay. I don't think they had that term back in 1967. No. We're supposed to be back in the park.
I don't know what to say. I'm sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. You are the producer and you're now in front of the microphone.
Okay. So anyways, let's get back on
topic. Okay. All right. Excuse me.
Sorry.
That is your producer quality and you're just trying to get us back on topic.
Yeah. Anyways.
So JStew, Little Joker.
Yes.
What have you been up to since we've last heard from you, because I think originally you were on the third podcast, man?
I don't know, something like that.
Something about the third podcast. Mm-hmm. You blessed us with that Smooth voice.
Shut up. Not too much. Just living my best life.
The best life is the greatest life. Yeah. You pretty much have a very nice life. Would you say that?
Yeah. I guess so.
You've got a lot of friends.
It's okay.
You've got a fantastic style.
Thanks. Even though I look kind of bummy right now.
But you also look like a producer.
What does that mean?
Well, you did take that content today.
Okay.
Should we talk about that?
So what are we talking
about? Should we talk about that?
Talk about what? What we?
Yeah,
what,
the content.
Down in Garden Grove?
Absolutely.
Okay. Just started out.
Down in Garden Grove, where the gardens are grovish.
Okay. It's,
are garbage.
Okay. Anyways, so down in
Garden Grove. Yeah, some guy stole from me a couple years ago. Or a year ago. And he didn't realize that we'd show up at his door. And so you, producer JStew, took video of it. And his mom's like, "I'm white trash. I got a dog. He don't live here no more."
Good thing he wasn't there. He would have gotten super heated.
Yeah.
Overheated. Oh, he would have gotten very
heated. It was all burned up.
Yeah. It would have been really burnt if he would have came out and then totally. It would have just been super sketchy.
It was almost like he would have been on fire with his anger.
Definitely. Third degree burns.
Third degree burns all over his body.
Specifically his arms.
Specifically his arms. It wasn't his face. But he does.
Have burnt arms.
True. He does look like a goddamn, was it lizard?
Yeah, like the
scales.
Skin, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, fucking idiot. God never liked you. So that's why you shouldn't steal $560 out of someone's bank account. Anyways, so we decided, like, pay a visit. You're like, "Steven, why are you getting dressed up in a suit? You look better in your Muay Thai shorts." And I said, "No, JStew. Gotta be taken care of. You gotta look better."
Mm-hmm.
For that white trash mama that answered that door. So we'll keep you up to date. If I do get my $560 back, I don't want to hurt you.
Really,
I don't want to hurt
you. Didn't
him.
Really tell them what happened.
Oh, well, the scaly motherfucker. Who had lived with, not live with me, he came over. The gecko, right? The Geico gecko.
Geico.
he shows up at my house one day, and he, like, tries to, like, talk to me and whatever. "Oh, great, good to see you. Wow, I heard you got burned trying to cook wax. That sucks."
What is Geico from? Allstate stands?
It's just like insurance.
Wanted to know if you're in good hands.
Well, he's definitely wasn't in good hands.
Don't make wax at home, kids.
That's pretty much it. Don't make wax at home. Unless you have a pool to jump into like he did.
Even then, I still wouldn't risk it. You might still get some fucked up arms.
Some fucked up arms. And that gets us to the word of the day.
Anybody burnt?
How do you know?
Is that right?
Anybody that says that, we have to scream it. Like we're on fire. You fucking idiot. So anyways, we get back to the story here. He was outside my house, JStew.
No, I wasn't.
Not you.
The gecko.
And he said, "You talked bad to me before.
Your hot spot.
I just need to use your hot..." Oh my god, he stole my hot...
Your hot spot. He wanted to get you...
Oh my god, I just realized it. This motherfucker jacked my hot spot out of the box. But how funny is that? Like,
he's only comfortable in hot settings.
Wow. Does everything have to deal with, like, fire with this motherfucker?
Maybe he just wanted to, like, maybe he, like, would put it on his face so that his, like, face could, like, warm up to the rest of his body.
Oh, my goodness. Well, you really...
cracked the code.
His skin is cracking. But anyways, we might cut all this out, but we might leave a little bit. He comes to the house, blah, blah, and he wants to pretend like he likes me, all the well knowing that he's going to rob me as soon as I go to sleep. And I'm with my other buddy who was like, "Hey, good to see you again," whatever. Mm-hmm. And then I'm like, "Hey, guys, I'm going to retire to my room on the other side of the Moraga Mansion."
That's my chance.
That's his chance, right?
He didn't even take your aloe vera. Just took it. All he wanted was All he wanted was your hotspot and a check.
That's right. And he stole one check out of my checkbook. And I know this because, A, we had him on camera. And B, he stole my hotspot and admitted to it. And then he tried to say he's got some attorney going, I've got this guy, Larry Anderson.
Where was he to fucking...
Where was he when
you
were to
on
say
fire, when you were caught on fire?
Yeah, he probably is in jail now or some shit. I don't know. Like, do you think he got... He might have gone to jail for that, right? Because he was cooking wax and he probably was facing, like, some time. I don't know if he did the time or not. But I know for a hot minute, it was... it was hell on earth. Anyways, kids, lesson to be learned. Do not cook wax in a shed.
Just don't do it, period.
Okay, just don't do it, period. There's enough wax out there. For you to, you know, now that weed is legal. Is wax legal?
Yeah.
Wait. It's wax is a very concentrated form.
Yeah, it is. Marijuana. Yeah, it's still legal. If you're...
Under the age of 18 to 21? Because I feel like that's where...
Well, I mean, if you have your...
medical, I feel like old people smoke weed.
If you have your medical recommendation, but like, you could get it.
18 to 20.
It's completely legal if you're 21 or older. And then otherwise, you have to have a medical doctor's.
Okay, so if you're 18, you can still smoke weed, but you have to have a medical license.
You have to have like a doctor's recommendation.
Right. And I had one of those, man, 6-7 years ago.
Wow.
And the doctor asked me, he goes, what's wrong with you? And I'm like, oh, I've got emphysema.
He's like,
well, then I'm not prescribing fucking.
Yeah, why would you say that if you were trying to?
I'm just kidding. I didn't say that.
It took me a second to realize that's not.
No, really, but I did. I actually did have a friend that did that.
That's stupid.
That's
my grandma has emphysema.
You just say glaucoma or pain or joints.
It's just you have trouble sleeping at night.
Doesn't matter, right? You could say anything but lung issues.
Yeah.
Well, anyways, he did that. But the doctor was hilarious, and I remember thinking like, wow, this doctor is really putting his life on the line to just. He's like, how far can you bend over, you know, touch your toes or whatever? And I'm like, oh, God, that's too far, doctor. And he's like, wow, you really, what happened to your back? And I'm like, I don't know.
I have a fucked up back.
You do. Constantly asking people to crack it for you.
Yeah.
But tell America or the world, tell them why.
Why my back's fucked up?
Yes.
I fell through a skylight at an elementary school. I was on the roof. I was jumping on the skylight when I was like 12 years old. Fell through and I landed on the bathroom floor at my elementary school. After, I didn't even go to the elementary school anymore. But
well, yeah, it would have been like 14 or something.
I was like 12 or 13.
12 or 13. Yeah, I hope you weren't going there then.
Yeah.
And so wait a minute, how far do you think you fell?
Probably like 15 feet onto like, onto cement floor.
Like just, bah!
Yeah, right on my back. My back's so fucked up to this day.
I know, you're always asking me, crack my back.
Yeah, I don't know if people think I'm like trying to be cute or something.
A little
like.
Bit.
Well, that's not the case.
I know.
I get genuine satisfaction out of getting my back cracked.
And you're what? How old are you?
42.
No, but for real, you can tell them. Right,
I don't give a fuck. I'm 18.
You're 18, right?
About to be 19 in like a month.
About to
be? Like a month and a half. Almost.
19.
Yeah.
And you're a producer at this young of age, but you're a superstar producer.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So, we're lucky to have your talents here. Thank you very much, little Joe. So, a lot's happened since, I know, the last episode that you were listening to, I had a particular girl on here, and she was fantastic. However, I think the Facebook Live audio translated a little better than the actual podcast.
Yeah, unfortunately, I haven't listened to your podcast in a while.
You know, it's funny, I haven't either. But if you have listened to it,
I didn't. It's okay.
Did you almost get it on the equipment?
No.
Okay, we're gonna take a shot to. We're now reaching our 13th episode. You know what that means? Lucky number 13. Okay. Ew. You take a shot for America.
America. Yeah, let's get that over.
We took a shot.
For Jish. Okay.
Anyways. Little Joker and Puppet.
Okay, Puppet, what's the next topic?
So in keeping with the topic.
What's next on the Hot Topics?
First of all, I would never set foot in a Hot Topic.
Well, that's Hot Topics, it's the Wendy Williams show.
Oh, and she has like something wrong with her.
Yeah, she does.
What's wrong with her? What does she have, like, emphysema? She has
Graves' disease. Or she has what? Graves' disease? Graves' disease? I don't know.
There's a thing called Graves' disease?
Yeah, I think she's just back on crack, honestly. She looks like it, and she acts
Was
like
she
it.
A man before?
And she lost... No, she isn't. She wasn't a man, but she lost... She's, like, lost a lot of weight over the years, and she used to do... She talks about, like, how she used to do crack when she would do her radio show at night. She was, like, talking... And I think she's back on crack. It really seemed like, and I think
she said she admitted to it.
Yeah, she talked about like how when she wouldn't get sober when she did the radio because it like made her career better. Like she would stay up all night on the radio.
Yeah, definitely. But I think she's back on crack.
Well, crack is whack.
Crack is whack, but I think she's
so in the studio. Like, was she hitting the fucking little crack pipe with the Brillo pad and all that kind of stuff?
I mean, I can't get specific with
sounds
you.
Sounds like
she,
you know.
Well, I mean, she's very open about it. She talks about how she used to do crack when she was on the radio show, but then she had to get sober.
Crack is terrible. Yeah. From what I understand.
Yeah, crack is... But anyways, yeah, long story short, I think she's back on crack. But anyways, what's the next topic?
So she just came out with this Graves' disease?
Well, she had to go... Well, no, it's... I've watched her on YouTube sometimes, and I've had this suspicion that she's back on crack, because she acts like it. She just acts smoked.
Well, she was kind of smoked out before.
Yeah, but she just, like, and her eyes, like, they just are huge, but she has a whole excuse for because she has Graves' disease, and that's what I heard. There's a whole excuse, and she had to go on a three-week break, and she kept fainting, on live TV, like, passing out.
Damn, how much crack do you think's in her body?
I don't know.
How much crack has been in her body?
A lot of
fucking enough
crack.
To kill, like, a little...
And, like, and also to her husband. Her husband, like, is cheating on her, too.
Really? At the same time she got Graves' disease?
She doesn't have Graves' disease. She has crack addiction.
Right, because you think...
That was a good cover. Right? It was a good cover. But it makes the whole excuse for the eyes that are probably... bulging out of her skull. But no, he's had a 10-year affair with this, like, girl who's younger than her.
That'll fuck up anybody.
Okay, anyway,
No, but what you're saying is that will actually... push a woman like herself, even if she has a
show. Yeah, but I think she's been back on crack before that, though.
Women are really weird about that.
Yeah.
If their husband is cheating on you with a woman that's younger, whew, I don't care if you have a TV show.
Yeah, and she...
I don't care if you got the number one show in America. I don't care if you're on The View.
Anywho, fuck The View.
Well, what other women's shows are that's actually, like, people watch?
There's quite a few. Anyways,
Kelly Ripa?
That's a male and female show.
Okay,
that's
what's a
Ryan
show?
And Kelly.
What's a woman's show? Besides The View.
The Real.
Okay, The View's bigger than that.
Well, yeah, I'm not saying big. You said what's another girl show. You didn't say what's a
big show.
But
you said The View wasn't that big.
Well, are we talking about like daytime
okay,
television?
Okay, name me
like
another woman's show that's bigger than The View.
Keeping Up with the Kardashians, probably.
Is that a woman's show?
I mean, it's based on women. Anyways, I don't even like Wendy Williams. I don't know why we got into this. What's next?
You don't like Wendy Williams? I think she's kind of real.
Sometimes I like the stuff she says, but then sometimes I'm just kind of like,
whoa, bitch.
Shut your fucking crack ass mouth. I agree. Like, sometimes I agree with what she's saying, but then sometimes I'm just like, keep, like, you're just like an angry old fucking
crack whore.
I was gonna say a fat bitch, but like, she's not even a fat bitch anymore.
Like the 80s call, I bet she was amazing in the 80s. They called and they wanted her back.
No, she was in in the 80s though, she was fat and on crack, so now at least she's skinny and on crack.
Skinny.
Yeah, and then
wait, what's your definition of skinny?
She's pretty skinny these days. Okay, if you look at her over the years of the show, she's lost a lot of weight.
I don't know, I haven't seen her on TV because she had Graves' disease.
Yeah, and then there's like a rumor that she, like, sucked Biggie's dick. And anyways, what am I talking? Just get on to the next topic.
Wait. When Biggie died at 23, right?
Yeah.
Okay, Wendy Williams must have been, what, 40 then?
No.
Wendy Williams was in her 50s.
Yeah, she's like my mom's age.
Right. Biggie died 20 years ago.
She was really big on the radio.
7 years older. She was on Hot 93 back then?
Or 97.
Hot 97, whatever the fuck it's called.
Yeah,
I'm not from New York, but it's Hot 97, right?
Neither am I.
Right, so she had to at least be like 30 when Biggie was 22.
Right? Yeah, sure.
So she wasn't a Biggie.
Yeah.
Maybe he made her a Biggie.
No, she was already Biggie. Mm. Anyways.
All right, let's move on.
Enough from Wendy.
We love her too much. We hope she gets better. If it's crack or if it's Graves' disease. Wendy Williams? Looking out for you, and we want you to get better. And we hope that that man is not satisfied with the much, 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 much younger woman.
Okay.
Okay. So let's move on to the next topic, right? The next topic is, I want to say thank you to everybody out there. I know that you've been listening, And maybe you haven't been listening because you're like, wow, what is Steven talking about? Why is he so over the top?
Why has he been talking about Wendy Williams for the past 8 minutes?
Hard edit. But why do you have a podcast? And I had to ask myself that. Why do I? Well, actually, I didn't have to ask it because I know fucking why. And I understand that maybe some people out there who've known me don't understand why I cuss.
Then don't fucking listen to it.
Exactly. But we're kind of switching gears a little bit here. It's not just going to be about the Wendy Williams of the world.
Okay, enough of I don't want to hear that name again.
Okay. It's not just be about that. It's not going to be about gossip so much. Or just what's going on in our lives, which I'm sure you're very interested in. If we're going to beat somebody down that's a burn victim, that's fine. But what we're talking about is real progressive change. And I'm not talking progressive like, oh, I'm a progressive, or oh, I'm a liberal, or oh, I'm a Republican.
Flow from progressive. Yeah,
because let me tell you something right now. If you think that you are either a Democrat, or Republican, a liberal, or conservative, that's the dumbest thing I could possibly imagine. You know why that is?
Why, Stephen?
Because it's like the people in power. Look at us, society, like a football game. So you have one side to cheer for, and you got another side to cheer for. And that's how fucking stupid they think we are. Because I understand, you know, maybe you, JStews, you have some leanings towards this side, or you have some leanings towards this side, but you are not completely one or the other. Correct? Everybody pretty much falls in that category over here. We should have a million parties. We shouldn't just have the Republican Party. We shouldn't just have the Democratic Party. We should have at least 20. I mean, not a million, but maybe let's say 20. How about that? Because everybody kind of falls in, I like this, I like that, I like this. Maybe people like gun control, maybe they don't like
gun control. Why can't there just be two and you can just make up your fucking mind?
Because the world is not black and white.
Well, then why do you have to have an answer?
Huh?
Why do you have to have an answer to...
I don't understand.
Like, what party you are? Why do you have to have a party?
I don't understand why you do. But
I don't.
That's where the world has shifted. You're either so liberal or you're so conservative that you gotta play politics like that. And that's ridiculous because who the fuck is... Like, so this way...
I just kind of repeat what my family says.
Right. And some of your family probably is a little more conservative. Right?
Yeah.
All right, but
no, I mean for the most. I don't. It depends. It's
exactly.
We're talking about the family I fuck with, or the family that I
fuck
with less. I don't not fuck with them, but I fuck.
Okay,
with
I don't know what the story of your situation is.
No, I don't need to get into it either. I'm just saying, yeah, there are some Republicans, and there are some Democrats, but I mean, for the most part, I think about the Democrats.
Understandable.
Yeah,
but you can like issues on both sides. Maybe some that are socially responsible, some that are fiscally responsible.
Mm-hmm.
But for the majority of people out there, I guarantee you, you don't completely agree with one side or completely because they're dumbing you down. Like, oh, it's a football game. We can cheer for this side or we can cheer for the other.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So people need to understand that. They're making you pawns to a certain situation.
It's not that deep.
It is that deep. And so what I'm saying is this. I'm just throwing that out there because we'd like to talk a little bit. We're not talking about any. We're going to talk about a little bit more social topics maybe.
Okay.
And I want everybody to know that my voice and yours now doesn't come from a particular movement or a particular side. It's just kind of how the world works.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't say I'm Democrat or Republican, you know what I mean?
I would say you probably lean a little bit more towards the Democratic side.
Yeah, for sure. Definitely.
Like more left,
yeah,
center.
Definitely.
Right? But I'm sure there's some things that you want might like over here, a little bit on this side, on the right side. Or I'm not talking about where I'm at, but I'm saying...
Yeah, I mean, not really. There's not really anything that I agree with on that side, but...
Really?
I mean, yeah, there might be. I don't have the laws in front of me. But
the law. See, we don't even know the law. So
whatever.
So if you don't even know what
I don't have them in front. I don't have them in whatever. I don't care. I don't want to. Don't try to make me sound uneducated.
I'm not. But I think that's the majority of people. They don't know what each side stands for.
Yeah. Right?
And I would think most people, if they listen to both sides, like, oh, I kind of believe that. I kind of believe this. I kind of believe that. I'm right here in the middle.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And so there should be, why do we have to vote for old white people over here or old white people over there?
No, I wouldn't say that I wouldn't classify myself as either one. You know what I mean?
Well, let me just tell you.
I wouldn't identify as.
Absolutely. The Democrats, I just saw, like, obviously everybody thinks the Republicans are old white people, right? Which I'm not disagreeing with. But then I just saw who the Democratic nominees for 2020 president were to go against Donald Trump.
Who is it, like Kanye
West? 89-year-old Bernie Sanders or whatever he is.
Oh my God, that's awesome.
That is awesome, but he might not even make it to 2020.
Stop.
Oh my God, he's almost 80 years old.
He's a great guy.
Absolutely.
Is Kanye West running?
No. But I know he said he was going to. But
I feel like he is going to. I want Oprah to run.
Yeah, and that would be interesting.
Yeah.
Right? But as of right now, it's Bernie Sanders, Joe Biden.
Well, that's kind of cool.
If we're talking about old white people, it doesn't get any more old and white than really two of them.
I'm down for both of them.
Okay. They may not even make it.
Who is like the other ones for like...
Well, Donald Trump is going to run for the Republicans because he's already the president.
Okay, I know.
So what they're trying to do is gather the best of the best that they got on their side, and they pick two old-ass white people.
Like who, like the
Carly? Joe Biden and fucking Bernie Sanders.
Who are the old people for Republicans?
Old-ass Hillary
Clinton. Not Donald Trump. Hillary Clinton's not a Republican. I said who are the old-ass Republicans is what I want to know, besides Donald Trump.
He's the only one that can run because he's the president.
They're not going to run. They can't have other Republicans run for president.
Who
for
ever,
the second term, even...
Okay, so Barack Obama ran for the second term. Do you think they're going to run a Democrat against him? He's already in the power.
Yeah.
That's how it works, my man. There you go.
Okay.
So who's ever the president, if he's on the Republican side, if he's on the Democratic side,
runs. I'm going to have to go with Joe Biden.
Okay, fine. And that's very, very fine. Yeah. And I think he's definitely lesser... Bernie Sanders,
Actually, I don't know. I don't really know. I like Bernie Sanders, but I feel like Joe Biden is a little bit more appropriate.
Right, and what is appropriate nowadays? We have no idea.
I don't know. I just feel like Joe Biden should be our next president.
Absolutely.
I feel it.
And so...
Oh my God, and then Obama should be our vice president.
Oh my God, he could be. He actually could be. Joe Biden and Obama, but it's like the reverse ticket.
Yeah, no, but honestly, I don't want Obama to be back. Want Obama to be back in the White House.
Wow,
I do want him to be back in the White House, but I mean, he looks so much happier and like less.
He totally does.
He looks so much less gray.
And his daughter can smoke weed where she wants to.
Oh,
what's her name? Melania.
Malia.
Malia. Melania is Donald Trump's wife.
Dumb bitch. Can't even speak English.
Well, she was born in a different country, motherfucker.
Okay, yeah, but then why does he have?
Why do you say that about that? What if it was a Mexican?
Okay, let me explain.
That was very racist.
Okay,
so
well,
you're
the only
definitely
reason,
not a Democrat.
The only reason I have that sort of animosity towards him is because he's so like tripping on wanting like Obama, where Obama was born, blah 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 blah. It's like, well, when have we even had like a fucking first lady that wasn't born in the United States? I have nothing against it. I think she's a very pretty woman. I honestly feel bad for her. She seems very sweet. I really would like the bitch. But
you probably would.
I probably would really like her, and I probably.
But she's a nice lady.
And she probably is a very sad lady too.
Maybe.
She's just kind of has to sit there, like be quiet in the background.
How do you know that?
You could just tell it. Like, when you think of Michelle Obama, like, you could tell Barack Obama takes advice. You could tell Barack Obama takes advice from his woman.
Or maybe more than advice.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, she runs the house.
Yeah, she could run for president. I'll vote for her. But
I don't know. Would her eyebrows run as her second in charge?
That's so funny. That's hilarious.
Because they're mean. They look meaner than the president.
That's hilarious. I think she's a beautiful woman.
I do.
Anyways, but then you could tell. Right, you could tell Melania. She's just kind of like.
There's a lot of black women. They're absolutely gorgeous.
Okay, Steven. So do I.
And Michelle Obama ain't one of them.
Okay.
I
don't need you to think Michelle Obama is beautiful.
Well, I mean, it doesn't mean that I should think she's beautiful because she's not.
She
looks mannered.
I don't really.
Joan Rivers might have got killed because she said a bad word about Michelle Obama.
Honestly, Joan Rivers'
throat gets pulled out of her neck.
Okay, yeah, Michelle Obama, no, I'm not judging her by her fucking face.
I'm judging by her daughter. Her daughter's pretty. Malia.
Okay, none of that family is all that in a bag of chips besides Obama.
Doesn't matter,
Barack Obama's pretty fine. Anyways.
Wow.
Anyways.
Well,
what I'm saying is that you could tell that Obama...
Really? You think Obama's fine?
Yes.
No shit.
Yes. But anyways, you could tell that...
Wow.
Why is that so surprising? I feel like most people do.
Really?
Yeah. Huh. Anyways, can I just spit something out? You could just tell that Melania, she's just kind of like, it's just kind of like, okay, shut up, look cute, you know what I mean?
Right.
You could tell, like, Michelle had some, like, had a word. You could tell she had a word. Yeah, like, not today, Barack.
Is that what she talks?
I don't know.
She talks like a robot.
I don't know.
Not today, Barack.
I sounded really weird right now. Yeah, no, but you could tell that he took advice from her. You could tell Melania, she probably doesn't even know how to do multiplication.
Wow. She's from a different country, now you're saying she doesn't know how to do multiplication?
Okay,
they don't have math in other countries?
Dude, just, okay, maybe she knows how to
do it. She's from a fucking first world country,
maybe she knows how to do it in her fucking language. I'm not doubting that, but
our language, math is not a language to be
okay.
Like,
but you, but it's like saying 4 times 4 is 16, but like in Spanish, you'd be like, uno, dos, tres, cuatro what? Times cuatro. You know what I mean? She can't understand. Whatever. Doesn't okay. If anyone, no one's gonna understand. What I'm
saying. No, because the number four is.
I know it's globally, universal. It is universal. But
whatever
do you
call
say
it,
four the same way that you.
It doesn't matter how you say it. It doesn't.
Okay, yeah,
it's not translated.
Yeah, you have a point. Either way, I just don't think she knows.
But well, you just said Melania doesn't know math.
I don't think she knows how to do math. I'm not because she doesn't do it.
That's hilarious,
dude. Have you seen her like talk? She's a dumb bitch. But I would love to.
Wow.
But that's just like as a first lady. You know what I mean? As a woman. As
I don't know.
I'm just saying.
She is the first lady. So yeah, how dumb is she?
Pretty dumb. Okay. As a first lady,
she got herself. I'm just
as a woman. As a woman. As a woman, I love and respect her. As a first lady, I think she's. Dumb, and I'd honestly rather have Ivanka be the first lady than her.
Okay, understandable, but all your opinions are based on what? Have you seen what Melania has done?
Yeah, I have. I've actually, as a woman, I really do think I would like her a lot, and I feel bad for
her.
So
Google what she's done in her first 100
days. She's like a model.
Why don't we do this? Why don't we do this?
She's like a model.
Michelle Obama's first 100 days as first lady, because I know how much you love her.
Yeah, dude.
I'm not saying that you're not wrong. Maybe Michelle Obama did fantastic things compared to this idiot.
I still feel like Obama's my president still. I don't even feel like Donald Trump's the president. Do you genuinely feel like Donald Trump is the president of the United States?
Absolutely. I support my president, no matter if it was Obama or Trump.
No, honestly, no. I mean, I don't want anything bad to happen to our president.
God, what are you saying? No, because I've talked to, you know.
Oh my God, see, if you're going to search Michelle Obama versus Melania Trump, she literally like quotes her speeches like word for word. I've already seen this. I've already seen this stuff. She literally.
Okay. Liz?
Hey, this is too much words for me.
I know, it's a lot.
There's just this one interview and, or like speech, I don't know, whatever. And she literally says word for word, like what, whatever.
Whoa, Melania on our GQ magazine. Oh, she's not looking bad. And older men, like, well, she's pretty. Yeah. But she's also way older.
I mean, she's
than
like
me.
Pretty for a first lady. You know what I mean? She's but not really that.
She's not,
she
not,
had her time.
She's
her
not Michelle Obama.
Time's up. Okay, that's different. But that Michelle Obama's more like patriotic.
Well, have you, okay, let me ask you a question. Did you ever read Barack Obama's book?
No.
Okay. So if you read Barack Obama's book, there was a woman in his life. And he's very adamant about she was the one that got away. And he loves her to this day almost.
Okay.
And it's almost like. I don't want to say this, but it's almost like he settled because Michelle was much smarter or whatever, and he was kind of told. And I don't want to put words in his mouth, but if you read the book, then you would understand.
Do you have the book?
I do.
Do you have it?
Absolutely.
I'm going to take it home. Where is it? Do you actually? I want to take it home with me. I want to read it.
Okay, I will give it to you. Can you sit the fuck down and we'll talk about this? You're walking around with Michelle Obama's statue.
The color
that I have
of her party?
I have, yeah.
Star blue?
I have a statue here located here.
Would you actually have that book? I'm
absolutely,
yeah,
right. And his name, and he went by Barry, growing up. And I think he's very relatable.
His mom's white.
No. Are you serious?
You didn't know that?
Get the fuck out of here.
Well, he's light skinned as fuck.
No.
Are you being sarcastic right now? You're being sarcastic.
Absolutely, I'm being fucking sarcastic. I read the goddamn book that he wrote. How the fuck do I know that?
Did you know his dad was like the president of like Nigeria or like
something? First of all, he was the president.
Or like the king or something.
First of all, his dad was a piece of garbage.
Whatever. Either way, he was still like the king of some shit.
He was not the king.
Or he had some sort of government job for a different
country. Maybe briefly, but he was like a drifter.
Okay, I'm not saying I fucking am stand for him.
He had multiple kids with multiple women.
Yeah, I know that.
His dad was a piece of shit.
I'm not saying Brock has anything to do with this. I'm just saying, did you know his dad had a past?
If it wasn't for his mother, he would have probably grown up like as a piece of shit like his dad.
Okay, I understand. I'm just saying, were you aware that his dad was like had some sort of government job for a different country?
Were you aware that his dad fathered many, many children?
Yeah, I was. I've been on Google before, and I've looked at Barack Obama's siblings.
Right, and how much they love him?
I don't know.
How much does he show them?
He has a lot of siblings, actually.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And how much does he show them love?
I don't give a fuck about Barack Obama's siblings.
Well, hopefully he does, but he doesn't.
Hopefully he does, but I don't care if he does or doesn't. I just hope.
And I'm not even saying maybe he doesn't, because maybe he was never close to them. Because you know why? Because his dad was a piece of shit.
Yeah, I have two brothers. I have two brothers I don't even know, basically.
Really, you do?
Yeah, half.
Okay, and who cares if you know him or not, right?
Yeah, I don't give a fuck about them.
Exactly. And Barack should.
Exactly. No, I don't think Barack Obama should care about his brothers. I don't give a fuck about David or Travis. So, like, why
should... Wait, hold on. You talking about Barack's brothers or your brothers?
No, those are my brothers. Dylan, I love you.
Absolutely.
But David and I have an Asian half brother also named Travis.
Okay, well you're just like
Brock. I don't give a fuck I could honestly find out that they were dead and I wouldn't care.
Okay, well you should run for president
and be like fuck my half brothers.
Yeah, you'd be just like Barack Obama.
I'm gonna be just like Barack Obama.
You would just be like Barack Obama if you ran for president. That's what I'm saying. Because you have history.
I have a dad that knocked up a bunch of bitches that. He couldn't even...
Absolutely.
He didn't even care to introduce him to all of his...
You have a white mother.
Yeah. I have a black father.
You do. So, I mean, you're pretty much...
My dad was also the king of Nigeria.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Garden Grove, maybe. Bolsa Grande High School.
If he was the king of Garden Grove...
He was like the king of Bolsa Grande.
He would allow us to get. He allowed us to go through the fire.
He wasn't even the king of. He's the king of, like, I don't know. Maybe.
Oh, if he was the king of Garden Grove, he let us go through the fire, the lemon and the wine.
No, yeah, he's not even the king of. He's like the king of shards.
Are you talking about that? A skeleton?
My dad, the king of shards.
Oh, wow.
Smoked out.
No, I think he might actually be.
My dad is.
I know your dad was Hispanic. Actually, that's this whole really? Time. I didn't have no idea your dad was white.
He's like Italian.
Your last name's like
Stuart
Hernandez.
Stuart.
Oh.
Marcoli, too.
Oh, Italian. Paisano.
Marcoli is a pretty Italiano.
Hey, Paisano.
Yeah, but honestly, I get more. My dad and mom are both Italian, but my mom is German. Sure.
Do you want to tell everybody like things are okay?
Well, tell my family.
Yeah, your family. Your podcast family.
Hey. What do you want me to tell them?
That everything, you've been through a lot of stuff.
No, I'm chilling. I haven't been through shit.
I understand that, but maybe people out there are going through some shit.
Well, I hope they're okay.
Mijo?
Oh, I really hope they're okay, though. Like, I really do. Like, I really do from the bottom of my heart. Like, I really hope they're okay.
Let's go back in time. Let's go back to a time when there was a simple life. 1967. We're ladies.
1924.
Men were men. Men dated women.
When men were allowed to hold another man's hand without being judged.
Oh, wow. But they could hold a lady's hand too without being judged.
No, it was weird if they held a lady's
hand. But now the lady would say, me too. Me too. This is not happening to me no more.
Me too movement.
It's a me too movement.
It's a me too.
Ay, cabrón muchacho.
Barack Obama, your dad's black? Me too!
Wow,
your dad's the king of Nigeria? Me too!
First of all, Barack Obama's king. Barack Obama's dad was not.
Yeah,
king
okay, I'll tell you what he was exactly.
Right, you look it up.
Okay.
We have other issues to talk about.
Okay. Let's talk about my issues. I'm just kidding.
Hey, you want to?
No, I don't. That would be a long ass podcast.
Absolutely.
Fuck
you. So. So, Joshua.
Yes. Okay, Barack Hussein Obama Sr. Mm-hmm. was a Kenyan senior governmental economist.
Until he found the bottle.
And the father... whatever.
I'm just kidding. So we've all found the bottle at some point.
Okay, so the only...
He just ran with it.
See, yeah, my dad was part of Nigeria territory, but not Kenya, but still...
Oh, your dad was part of Nigeria too.
Have we not talked? Barack Obama's dad was never a part of Nigeria. Oh, that was my dad.
Oh, that was your dad. That was my dad. So, oh, he was part of Kenya.
Kenya. But, like, we're, like, we were, like, our
tribe. We now know your political leanings. But to the world out there, we're done talking about...
Barack Obama and Wendy Williams.
Yeah. Barack Obama, Wendy... Wow, we just destroyed two black people. That's really racist by two white people. Actually, two Hispanic. Little puppet, little joker. I'm a puppet.
Okay, but I'm half black.
Oh, yeah, your dad's a king of Nigeria.
Yeah.
So, I'm not going to send you money over the internet.
You send it through Western Union. That's when my dad sends me money. And he can't even get my middle name right. It's like all the way from...
And his middle name is his first name. Your middle name is his first name.
No, my middle name is the same middle name as his.
Oh, yeah, right. Well, it has something to do with him.
Yeah.
Wow.
He thinks I have my brother's middle name. But also, keep it... Granted, he doesn't know me, so I don't blame... It's okay. I think it's kind of silly.
Maybe he doesn't know
you. We don't really know each other that
well. Can you tell America what happened? How influential I was in you and your dad coming together?
I mean, you influenced me, like, getting, like a Western Union... A Western Union check once a month.
Okay, listen. He's not doing this story justice.
So I have a father.
You're telling me about the problems of your father.
Not really my problems, because I don't really give a fuck, because I don't really know him. He doesn't really know me that well.
Right. He didn't take the time to know
you. Yeah, I mean, I've met him. Did
your family keep you away from him?
No, he did. It was a little bit... I mean, I had an opinion on him because of my family.
Absolutely.
But it's not like they were holding me back from him. You know what
I mean? It's not like he couldn't visit you every weekend if he wanted.
Yeah, exactly. That was like a personal choice that I... had, but also though, I just
that's understandable.
Yeah, no, but I mean, I don't blame my family for having that opinion on him, because I still have the same opinion that they...
Well, can you flash forward to when you and I were hanging out, I think it was after a podcast, for instance, possibly,
uh-huh.
And I said, hey, you don't really know him. Let's call him.
Well, yeah, no, I have like, a legal adult. Yeah.
Legal immigrant.
Me finally being able to get my citizenship.
So wall is not for you.
Okay, no. Just kidding.
Keep it me, in.
Okay.
You can't go nowhere.
Okay. Anyways.
You have to stay at America.
Okay, shut up. me being a adult that is not, like, whatever. Me being an adult, I would feel kind of bad if I had, like, a kid that... I wanted to speak to that just, like, considered me dead to them. You know, because that's what I didn't even really think about him. He just was kind of...
It's weird.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, I would feel kind of bad, like, if I was trying to reach out to this kid and then everyone's like, sorry, he doesn't want to talk to you. Because he would want to ask my brother to talk to me, and my brother would be like, he doesn't want to talk to you, because I didn't. And everyone would be like...
He kind of made some inroads, but...
Yeah, like, he wanted to get in contact with me, and, like, I have a cousin that's on his side of the family, and, like, he would try to, like, add me on Facebook, and, like, it was just... I felt like it was kind of like my dad, you know what I mean? Trying to, like...
Absolutely.
So, but then I just never wanted to talk to him, and I was like, okay, I would...
So maybe in his eyes, maybe he's like, man, like, I tried, yeah, but I mean, they all blocked me.
Well, no, I was probably the only one that... Me and the Asian one are probably the only one that blocked him.
Wait a minute, he has an Asian...
Yeah,
Asian brother.
Travis. I've never met my brother, and my brother used to, like, work with my dad, and they went to Lowe's one time, and they bumped into my fucking stepbrother or whatever, half-brother, and my...
Wait a minute.
They bumped into my half-brother and his ex-wife.
He's Asian.
Yeah.
How do they know?
My dad can recognize his ex-wife.
Granny?
Yeah. Name's Gwen. Isn't that crazy though? I literally have like a Vietnamese fucking brother out there.
Well,
anyways, and I have another brother that's like...
Could fantastic. You know, you and me, we went to father.
Anywho. Yeah, maybe they work there.
Fantastic.
Anyways. I felt...
Yeah, beef balls.
Okay, we keep getting off topic. I felt kind of bad, and then Steven was just kind of making me feel like, oh, maybe you should talk to your dad. And then I was kind of... And my mom has been crazy, pretty crazy these days, so I was kind of like, maybe I should hit up my dad.
Yeah, and I kept saying it over and over.
Yeah, and then we got on the phone, and that, you know, I mean, it wasn't...
And then we put him on speaker.
Yeah, he called you off your phone.
Right, and he goes, who is that man?
No, he didn't.
He said something like that.
He said, whose friend are you? Yeah, he said, who is that man? Anyways, Yeah, no. So then afterwards,
I just felt like you guys, you know, it's been a long time since you talked, and I thought that maybe.
Yeah, no. You guys, and you no, know thank what? You. Really, I get an. Really I get one. Me... I get one extra. I get one more extra check because of you.
Well, you're welcome. You're welcome. But that wasn't my intention.
That was kind of. Anyway.
Well, kind of.
No, really. It wasn't really.
I just wanted you guys to connect.
Yeah, I just don't really have much to say. Don't really know you that well, but
Who, me or your dad?
I don't know you at all. Just kidding. No, my dad, obviously, I know you. that sounds funny. My dad, obviously, I know you.
Obviously, my dad. I don't know him for
no,
sure.
But, no, yeah, no. But, no, we talk, and I don't know. Now when we talk on the phone, it's kind of awkward, and he's very aware of the fact that I feel awkward, too, though. So he's kind of just like, sent you some money. Here's the code. I'm like, okay. He's like, trying to, like, make small talk. He's like, all right, well, let's keep in touch. I'm like, yes. Thank you for, like, making this phone call shorter.
Yeah, because my opinion on it was, like...
No, I get
it. No, listen, hold on one second.
Okay. Oh.
A, you're a very intelligent guy. B, you're a very caring guy. C, if your dad doesn't know you and doesn't know that part about you...
Mm-hmm.
Also, C, you are a very talented guy. And also, D, if your dad... If I were your dad, I would be very sad when I die to not know what a talented... charismatic son that I had and have that kind of relationship with him, and maybe he was scared of your family or I don't know the
no,
situation.
No, he would try to get in touch with me, but he just didn't ever through I Nigerian did, I, did money? Not, I did not what?
Through Nigerian money.
No, he would like talk. My brother like kept in touch with him. My brother doesn't really care for him that much. Like me and my brother were both
really
like, he doesn't really care for him that much, but he's like that. My brother had more of a relationship with him because my
brother's so the brother knows him.
Yeah, well, yeah, my brother is 6 years old. My brother is 6 years older than me.
He still doesn't like him.
Well, yeah, because he actually saw the shit that the reason why my mom feels the way she feels about him. So, like, yeah. Yeah. And it's not like he was just, like, a bad dad to me. Like, he wasn't really a dad to any of his.
To his Vietnamese kids.
Yeah, to the Vietnamese kid doesn't even. The Vietnamese family, they don't even really know him. She, like, my grandma.
Where? West Spencer over?
I don't know. My grandma and my grandma and my mom would always talk about how, like, she was smart and she got out right away. But then before he,
the Vietnamese kid is older than you.
And older than my older brother Dylan too.
Oh. Fuck.
He has no, and there's an older brother older than the Vietnamese brother named David.
That's the one you're talking about.
No, I mean that's the one that I like slightly kind of know of.
How old is he?
Probably like your age.
2019?
I think my dad had him really young.
Yeah, I would say what, 32?
Yeah, however old you are.
Fine, thank you. Keep going.
Shit.
Trying to do a fucking podcast here, goddammit.
See, look, doesn't he look, does he not, he oh, looks, God. He looks older than are you short? For sure.
Oh my. You're trying to tell me that guy's my age?
Well, I think he's older than you, I just know he's not,
He looks like the guy that did OxyClean. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
He's the guy with the beard.
Yeah.
But he died, because he was all coked up or something. Not your brother, I'm sure he probably wasn't coked up. But who's the guy from OxyClean? He used to yell at the TV. Or he used to yell at it. He used to yell at it. The big beard in the dark and stuff. Like he dyed the same color as him.
Yeah. Yeah.
But whatever. Well, I'm glad that we've gone down memory lane with you and your brothers.
I'm glad glad we got to reminisce on my deadbeat dad.
If your deadbeat dad's out there.
He's out there tweaking it somewhere.
Wow.
Somewhere in Oregon or Arizona.
Okay. if David.
David,
if you're out there. And you want to talk to your... It just so happens you stumble upon this podcast.
You have my number.
You have Josh's number.
And you have my Facebook.
And what's the other guy's name?
My brother. Which brother?
With me.
Travis.
Travis.
I wonder how old he actually is.
Hold on.
He's probably 27, 28. My brother's 25.
Wait a minute.
5? 24. My brother Dylan. My actual brother.
Huh?
My actual brother. I wonder how old he is, because my actual brother Dylan is...
Are you going to say something to Dylan right now?
No, I'm just trying to figure out how many years older he would be than Dylan, because Dylan's like 24, 25.
Okay.
But so maybe like 28 or 29.
But to your...
This is all for your brother...
Let's start with your brother Travis. To your brother Travis, we'd like to say... Zin chao, Travis.
That's... No, honestly, that's kind
because,
of... That's kind of
because... Josh is waiting for you. He just wants to get to know you.
No, I don't.
So, at the very basic level...
I literally said previously in this podcast, I don't care if they died.
Xin chao. There you go. Look at you're meeting him halfway.
Xin chao, Travis.
There you go. So to Dylan, we say
Dylan.
No, Dylan just wants to go see a movie with
Dylan.
Him, right?
I love you.
Yeah, Dylan.
Dylan, I love you, David. I don't know her.
Her. Oh my God! Is he transitioning?
No, it's a Mariah Carey thing. When they'd be like, she'd be like, I don't know her. When they'd ask her about Jennifer Lopez.
Okay, well, you know,
Dylan. Shout out to Dylan.
Shout out to Dylan. Love you very much, my man.
Hey, anyways, I'm done talking about my fucked up family.
There you go. They're not fucked up. You know what they are? They're your family.
Yeah.
And it's the only one you got.
No, it's okay that they're fucked up. It's not an issue.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
It's the best.
Yeah.
In the world.
Yeah, no.
Because that's what made you, and everybody out there.
Uh-huh.
To everyone out there. If you think it's like a lonely path, if you think you're the only one going through stuff, well, just listen to Josh's story and you're not the only one.
Yeah. So, life could be a lot worse.
Absolutely, life could be a lot worse.
I have a fucked up dad, doesn't like half of the world.
How about this? If you were born in Nigeria or if you were Barack Obama's dad, probably where he grew up, you had to walk 50 miles for water.
Yeah,
we grew up living.
I feel blessed. I feel blessed. I didn't have to know my father.
You grew up in Huntington Beach.
I didn't have to know my father. That was a blessing.
Well, your father put you in Huntington Beach.
My mother.
Your mother.
Yeah.
But your father's little people swam to your mother. Did that in Huntington Beach, maybe?
No, you're born in Oregon. In Oregon, yeah, I was born in Oregon.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, I was an accident.
No.
Which I think is great.
That's right. I think you know what? Some of the most amazing people.
Well, no, it wasn't like an accident. It wasn't like an accident. My dad and my mom were just kind of done. Well, I'm not even supposed to know this, but like my dad and my mom were just kind of, they weren't divorced yet, but they were just kind of done. And then they were kind of separated.
But you know from experience, you know, maybe if they wanted to reconcile, your dad's like, it's going to make us closer. Right there.
And
she's all, what the fuck did you just do?
No, and then she's like, oh shit. And then the doctor.
Yeah, she's like, what did you just do right now?
My brother, when me and my brother Dylan got into a crazy fight, he was telling me all this crazy shit about me before I was born. And he was saying, like, I was at this doctor's appointment. They were like, I don't think you should have this baby, Marie. Like, the doctor's like, you're not
like in the 18th trimester.
Yeah, no, there's three.
I have no idea. I don't have kids.
This is just
three trimesters only?
Yeah, one, two.
How the fuck do I know? Oh, yeah, trimester.
Anything
to do with kids,
When me and my brother would get in a fight, he would like try to like hold it. He'd be like, you're a fucking accident. I remember them telling them, trying to convince mom not to have you. But then she decided to have me. She probably wishes now. I'm like, fuck, I should have scrapped you as a fetus.
Well, that's
the sad story. Oh my God, I'm not trying to make this all deep and sad.
It is a little deep.
Oh.
Okay. Well, if it hadn't been for you, this podcast might not get off the ground. And there are probably millions and millions of people out there listening that maybe this podcast has helped them.
Please pray for me. Honestly, I'm not okay.
There you go.
I need everyone's prayers.
So everybody, let's get together right now.
Why?
Let the Lord be with you. I feel like
I was having a pity party for
my God. Oh my God, who the hell cares?
Thank you. Who the hell cares?
We already prayed for you.
Yeah, okay, no, but genuinely.
But everybody out there, if you want to take time on your own to pray for Josh, just send your money to 5,000.
Send your money to
5,000 Birch Street, Suite 3000, in the West Tower, Newport Beach, California, 92660. Thank you. Make it payable to Josh too.
Thank you. I would really appreciate that. All donations, like,
just to get him off the street.
Thank you. Anyways, next topic. I've had enough of my
next topic. So there's a couple of topics I want to touch upon.
Okay, let's get this done.
So as you know, there's this whole thing about. Did you understand that maybe a month ago, maybe a little more than that, some kids got killed?
The shooting?
Some kids got killed in
Florida.
Right?
I used to live in Florida.
I used to visit Florida.
I used to live in Cocoa Beach.
Wow. I used to.
The area code was 321.
Well?
Okay, anyways. Yes, I did hear about that.
I've been to Orlando.
I think that's great.
Fort Lauderdale.
I'm happy. Anyways.
Daytona Beach.
Okay, awesome. Okay, let's talk about the shooting.
Was that one Gainesville? That one too.
Boynton Beach. Anyways.
Miami is dope.
Yeah. Anyways, could we just talk about the shooting?
Okay.
And how stupid it is?
And so how
terrible. Okay, it's not stupid. It's very sad. It's very sad.
Stupid.
It's very I just think it's stupid how much attention. How much attention.
Yeah, like, what?
For how long.
Okay, let me just ask you a question, Josh. Did you know this? The chances of you dying from the flu this year
Yeah, I agree. It's very slim. Your chances of dying in a school shooting are slim to none.
Yeah, and I hate to break this to the parents of the school shooting or Sandy Hook or wherever. Horrible tragedy. Yes,
absolutely. I agree. I wish it never happened.
But y'all some lucky, unlucky motherfuckers. Yeah. That just is what it is. If my kid died in a school shooting,
they would be unlucky too. You should not feel scared to send your kid to school.
Absolutely not. The chances of your kid going to school and being shot by a classmate are literally...
Even if you have the, even if you're one of the unlucky ones and your school gets shot up, you're probably not going to be the one.
Well,
to
you know
shot.
What I'm going
to
do? I'm gonna get to know those parents and then send my kid to the same school. And like, it's just kind of like, why? Because if their kid was get shot again, that would be like the legitimate. Yeah,
and
like,
then,
wow,
and then also
it's
just like, why do all these kids? They have to like. They're like people at their school died and stuff, so now they're gonna suck their own dick on TV and like
it. Yeah, I don't understand it. Like, I understand these kids want to make a difference.
Yeah, I get they want to share their story. Cool, share their story next.
It's were they been, were they in this were they in this particular classroom or building?
Yeah, they make yeah.
No,
regardless, I understand. And they're saying, regardless, I understand it's very scary.
And no, understandable. And it's very sad. And they're kids, and you don't want to like
and it's
take
very
away from their passion.
Sad, but it's kind of also like they're
shut the
they're
fuck
milking
up.
The fuck out of this story.
And if, so
they're milking.
If I were them, and Time Magazine came to me and said, "We want to put you on the cover," you know what I would say? And I'm at the head of this fucking movement. I would say, "No, no, no, don't put me on the cover." Put the victims on the cover. We are
well, maybe,
not. We are not
yeah,
the ones.
I agree. That's the right thing to do. But I mean, maybe I would feel differently if I was personally offered. But at the same time, it's
yeah,
just kind
of because you're a fucking egotistical maniac.
Okay, but at the same time, though, I feel like these. It's just kind of they're milking the fuck out of this, and it's just kind of like
yeah.
let it like
have you ever gotten to one of these kids like Twitter pages or whatever before? This Nicholas Cruz.
They're probably
kid.
Ignorant as fuck, and now they're
yeah,
like now they're like yeah, no, and they're probably said a bunch of ignorant shit that was just not.
But now they're the voice of a nation.
Now, yeah, they're the voice of
and,
Florida.
But you know what? Not just Florida, the nation. They were on Capitol Hill.
Yeah, no, I don't know why I said Florida.
Yeah, Miley Cyrus was singing. They yeah. got Martin Luther King's granddaughter. They got a whole mess of people, yeah. like thousands.
Yeah.
And what makes me like, I don't understand because the people that are following them, you got Anderson Cooper. Like, what is it about? You guys are so amazing. I guess, but they're just kind of like
why? Because they why? Because they unfortunately were at went to a
yeah,
school that
like
got shot up.
Student,
why are they so like
student council got excited about stuff, and now they're getting like and you know what? It's not their fault. They're kids, and they're getting really riled up. In fact, the one
and no,
David
people,
had,
and they have definitely
David
have
had,
a
like,
bit,
hit,
definitely,
hit his chest, and then he
no,
went like
and they
salute.
Definitely have a
and
bunch,
the other girl was wearing an armband like Nazi shit. What,
no,
what
and they
fuck?
Definitely like have a gang of adults behind them that are like absolutely. That are a that are making them that are, like, fueling,
them,
that are fueling this
right. Because if the adults were to do it,
yeah,
nobody well, would, yeah, yeah. They're not the kid.
But if a bald girl that...
absolutely, with a military jacket with an armband on it.
Yeah, she's so relatable.
She's not to me.
No, me neither, but...
There's probably millions of girls that...
She just has the no. face. She just has the... She has that face, though. You
she
know what I mean?
Face that, that,
face,
to, that,
that face
that needs to be buried.
That... She has that. Like,
I mean, in, no, no. I mean, in silence.
She has that face that, like, well, she has that. She has love. That face that is
that even her mother doesn't like.
No, not no. She has that her like. She has terrible. That face that she's like. She would be. She looks like she would be a feminist. She looks like
she
would be.
Like,
she looks,
hang out with her.
She yeah. She looks like she'd be a feminist. She looks like she would be all for.
You know what? I'm all for her movement, except just keep it to yourself.
Yeah, or it's just I'm
because
just,
look,
I was
16,
I
was 17,
was all for the
I was 18.
I got it for the first week or two.
You're 18, and you're like, oh, what the fuck are they
yeah,
about?
No, I got it for the first week or two. I was like, this is very sad.
Absolutely.
But it's just kind of like, okay, a month has
passed. They hijacked these kids. Like,
yeah, no, a month has passed. You're not like a public
yeah,
figure to me. I don't know, care or
right.
know about who you
but
are.
They keep shoving
why do I keep seeing you? I don't want, I don't know
there's
you.
There's been so many shootings.
Yeah. You don't have heard. A, you don't have a personality for... Show business, you have
but
no...
But not only that, like, let's talk about, you know, texting while driving. You know how horrible that is?
Okay.
No, I'm saying that's a real move.
Definitely.
Like, can we just, I know that a lot of states, I think, I would say the majority of states you can't text while driving, right?
Definitely.
But it's still an epidemic.
Okay.
Where's the revolution?
Yeah,
flag?
But I'm not going to say, I'm not going to be like...
Did you know in 1993, Josh?
Uh-huh.
1993. Okay. 1993, the rate of killings in schools...
Mm-hmm.
Before the Columbine incident, before that, was much higher. But you know what's upsetting about that? Is they were killing ghetto kids, right?
Uh-huh.
And nobody gave a fuck about it. It's not until it goes
white
to these
kids,
white schools
yeah.
that people start getting really excited about it. And no offense, I mean, a killing is a killing. I get that. But where the fuck were these activist then.
Yeah, no, definitely. Like once
because the killing rate was much higher. Once
it starts affecting the white people.
Absolutely. The opioid epidemic. Oh, wow. You know what? The opioid epidemic has been hitting the inner city more than you could possibly imagine.
Once white Americans get affected, then it becomes a...
Oh, now it's a national phenomenon.
Yeah, definitely.
Right. And now we got kids on Capitol Hill doing Nazi salutes or whatever.
Yeah.
Half versions of it.
Whatever.
And so I just don't understand it. Like, of course, maybe it brings something to the conversation. Of course. Of course. Maybe there needs to be some kind of... Of course, that kid should not have been able to buy an AK at 18 years old. I think maybe it has to be... If you have to be 21 to buy a Glock in Florida, you should be 21 to buy an AK then. If that's the rule, then that's the rule. Of course. But you know who...
They should be able to properly...
But did you know? Did you know that the cops were out at that kid's house 14 times? Some of them.
Really?
14 times. They should be able to... And there was a lady from Louisiana... And another person from Florida. Everybody saw his
they
post.
Should be
there was a miss of law enforcement. It's on law enforcement.
No, definitely. They should be able
and the
to
kids even, sorry.
They should be able to properly assess people who are buying guns and be able to tell.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? They should be able to actually tell if they're a fucking
mental idiot.
Yeah, not be able to just be a freaking idiot that's able to like say the right thing.
With the amount of guns that are out there, if everybody used them for bad.
I mean, I don't really...
We wouldn't even be able to walk outside. Yeah. We just have bullets flying.
Yeah, I mean, I really don't think that there should be guns or needs to be guns, but I also know
really?
That... Well, I mean, I also understand that, like, it's a fucking right, and you should... I just don't really... I don't like them.
Okay, so, understandable.
You know what I mean?
Understandable, but do you know why the Second Amendment is what it
yeah,
is?
Yeah, no, I know.
And I'm not saying the NRA is right, because
I
think they're
kind of exactly. That's why
weird ass
organization to be. I'm just saying, if I got to, like, if I was the president, I wouldn't really...
You just ban guns?
Yeah, I wouldn't really
want... You know who also banned guns? The Nazis.
Okay, well, that's... I'm just saying, I wouldn't really want... And I would want to ban every gun ever.
Fine.
You know?
Then what? Evil people... Whatever. They'll be like, we can't get guns now because Josh, the president...
Whatever. I just don't really think guns are necessary, but I also don't really... I'm...
Bad people are going to have...
Yeah, no, guns. I'm also not going to be like, oh my God, like, gun...
A gun-toting idiot, right? I get you. Because most of the people...
I mean, like, I get it. Guns are going to be around today. Guns are going to be around.
Do you know why the Second Amendment is the Second Amendment,
though? What is that again? The Ahas?
I have no idea. The house.
Like, thou shall bear.
It's not the Ten Commandments.
Like, the right to bear arms or something?
Right, the right to bear arms, right. So, but do you know why? Because our founding forefathers did not want the government to be... If the government was powerful, they wanted the people to be able to protect themselves against the government, right? And at the time, they wanted to issue military-grade weapons to the people so that they have military-grade weapons so the government, if they were to get too powerful, right? So the right now, the government has military-grade AKs, right?
Mm-hmm.
Even more than you can't buy the ones that the government has, right? Which is unfortunate. But if the Second Amendment is this, then we should all have tanks, right? Because that's the idea behind it, is that the government shouldn't be bigger than the people, right? So why don't we have tanks?
I mean, maybe you could buy one.
I'm going to tell you right now, if the government wants to smash you, they will smash you. But come in, and you can have an AK all you want to, motherfucker.
Like, can we go to the next topic? I'm getting kind
of... Right. So what I'm saying is, there's a lot of issues here. There's a lot of layers, and maybe they're bringing this to the forefront, and that's what they want. And you know what? More power to you, David Hogg and Emma Gonzalez or whatever. It doesn't really matter what your name is because nobody's going to date your ass once you turn like fucking 21 because God damn it. Like high school girls are supposed to be good looking. So once you turn 21, your ass is fucking, whoa, holy shit.
Okay.
Holy shit.
Okay, continue.
Wow.
Could we do the next topic?
Wow. But maybe that's what she wants. I mean, obviously. She is the voice of a...
Of fucked up Lilith America.
Fair?
Or dead.
The Lilith Fair?
Or the voice of dying schools.
Dying pets?
The voice of the voice of dead school kids.
Oh, shit. So anyways, we're not even getting to my Instagram stuff.
Thank you for speaking for all of the...
Thank you for speaking for all the dead school
kids. For all the dead kids that didn't even
you
like
know.
You. And you didn't even have... I bet you weren't even close friends with any of them either.
Right?
You just had the right look. She just had the right look.
Right.
Yeah.
Duh. Now you're getting it.
Yeah.
They picked the one that had the right look.
You probably didn't even really know anybody.
I would love to see her.
I bet you the closest relation she had to someone that got shot was like her friends.
I would have liked to see if she would have ever tried to befriend that fucking crazy eyed idiot that shot everybody up. I'm not even saying his name.
Why did everyone have to be that kids was probably really bullied and stuff?
Absolutely.
Why were kids just, you know what I mean? Maybe if kids were nice to him and didn't make him feel like such an outcast.
That's interesting that you say that because.
You know what I mean? That maybe less thing.
That's interesting that you say
that
because.
Shouldn't be a fucking
asshole. Coming December of this year, it's called What's the Play? And if this kid had that social application, maybe somebody were to listen to him.
Yeah, no, definitely. And, like, I bet you he, like, nobody wanted to hang out with him.
You know? I mean, it doesn't excuse what he did.
No, definitely. But it was like, maybe if people didn't make him, he was obviously a weird fucking
kid. Why didn't David Hogg talk to that kid?
Yeah, no, definitely. There were...
They're too busy, like, saying, oh, this guy's a fucking psycho.
I mean,
Don't let him come.
Yeah, no, I mean, I definitely think he's a fucking lunatic.
Yeah,
but I mean, I bet you if people didn't, if everyone at his school didn't think of him as a lunatic, maybe...
Or...
Maybe he wouldn't have wanted to shoot up everyone at that school.
Absolutely. Or, on the flip side, anybody has those crazy eyes, you just arrest them, do a citizen's arrest on them, and then just get them out of society.
Yeah.
Just, anybody has crazy eyes like that, it's not about black, white, brown... Yellow, whatever the fuck.
Like a certain look.
Just anybody that has crazy eyes. Do not take the law. I'm going to tell everybody out there, take the law in your hands, put a little knapsack over them and say citizen's arrest, and then just get them.
Which is the next topic.
Just get them out of society. If you have crazy eyes, get out of here.
Okay, next topic.
Right? That would have saved many lives.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Next topic.
Okay, no, next topic. Like, I'm just over it.
No, I understand. I think it was
fun. I know exactly what they've been doing for the last whatever. Okay?
No, I understand.
But I just was like, man, what's wrong with you? If you're going to follow me, and then I follow you back in 1 week. I mean, at least stay following me for like 30 days, you dummy. You know? Like, then drop off.
Mm-hmm.
But literally, these motherfuckers will follow me. Like, and then I'm like, oh, okay. I don't really know if I like you. But since you went through the whole thing and followed me, all right, I'll follow you back. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Not that I even care about your real estate stuff or the fact that you think you're an entrepreneur or the fact that you think you're like a guru of like self-help or something.
Mm-hmm.
It's ridiculous. I would have never found you had you not found me.
Yeah, I agree. It's very
true. Right?
I agree. It's very
true. Yeah, but the thing about it is all of a sudden, boop, they're gone. So all I did was decide to call these motherfuckers out.
Hey, dummy.
Yeah, I said, hey, dummy. what's wrong with you? Like, you know, I did the nice thing and followed you back. You found me, you fucking idiot.
Yeah, they all had something to say. If I was someone that followed someone just to unfollow, I would just probably block you afterwards and be like, I don't know like you. I would never want to have a conversation about the fact
because all of them said like, ooh, it's not me, it's my team, or it's the thing.
Like, you're fucking lying.
It's the idiots and the nobodies like you that I'm like counting on or some shit. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, first of all, I'm a man, like, I think this era is changing. This paid reach. I understand that they want their ratios to be, so I'm saying this to everybody out there. I'm going to discount everybody else. I'm going to follow everybody. And my ratio is going to be like, I'm going to have the least followers. So I'm going to have the most following.
What is the last topic? This topic isn't really that interesting.
No, well, I'm coming out with a...
Documentary.
No.
I think what you have to say about it is all funny and stuff. I just feel like there's like, this isn't really that entertaining or interesting.
Because you've already heard it. Last night you thought it was fantastic.
Well, yeah.
Right. So they haven't.
Yeah, I just don't think this is a setting to explain it.
What, after we talked about your family and your Nigerian prince dad?
No, never mind. I'm not sure.
And then the gun, lesbian that like is now the gun movement person.
Okay, yeah, never mind.
And the
never
fact
mind.
That,
this is your show. I'm sorry.
Thank you. And the fact that we're listening to smooth sounds.
Mm-hmm.
Go back on Instagram, right? Are you on the gram right now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let me know if they got you. So anyways, one of them listened to my podcast. Thank you very much. So his name's Rain, I guess, with the Y. You can follow him at Rain, who gives a fuck.
Yeah.
Right? Right, exactly. And but what's funny about every one of these motherfuckers that I called out, they wanted to keep getting the last word in. In fact, the black people said, have a blessed day. And I'm like, really, dude? That's pretty standard. You know what I mean? Really, have a blessed day, huh? That's something that I've never seen before.
Yeah.
You know, like, that's very stereotypical. And I'm upset at you for doing that. But he, like, he's like, it must be my team.
You don't have a fucking team.
Absolutely.
You don't have a fucking team.
Exactly.
Your team of your 10 fingers.
Right. And one dude tried to shame me. That guy, Rain, or whatever. He tried to shame me because I only got 300. Like, man.
What is that fucking
Who mean? Gives a fuck? Like, I live real life.
Yeah, that's...
That's just my personal, like, home.
I'd rather have 300 followers and friends than...
Yeah, what is that?
Than 1,000 followers and...
Right.
That 1,000 followers and nobody wants...
And nobody cares about you.
Can look you in the eye because...
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Like, it doesn't mean shit. And if you want to, and this is a lesson to everybody out there, if you want your ratios to be down, just think about me. I'm going to get rid of everybody that follows me, and I'm going to follow.
Just make a new Instagram.
If you see me out there and I'm following you, it's because I want to get the most follows with the least amount of followers. I'm going to switch it up.
So original.
Well, have you seen it?
No. What's the last topic?
Wow, that's it. We're done.
Oh, kill him. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, kill him.
What's Blvd.net? Peace, y'all.
Yeah.
My eyes shut.